Hello guys, this is Vysh. So today is the fourth episode of Vysh News Updates. And the headline is 70% of Russia's Sputnik vaccine is to be manufactured in India. Okay, so that headline we'll just like cover in just 2 to 3 slides because a new vaccine is coming to India. But in this video, we'll discuss the efficacy of all the vaccines which are available. Like Covaxin is there, Covishield is there, Sputnik is there. These three are the ones which government has approved for emergency use in India right now, as of now when we are recording this video. So we'll see which is better. Okay, that is a question which people ask, like now vaccination is open, so which one should I take, this one or that one, or just based on availability I can take whatever I want. So we will see in detail, like what is Covaxin and what is Covishield and how is it different from each other and how is it different from other vaccines which is there across the world. Okay, so it'll be a quick 5 to 8 minute video, so people who are interested can watch this. And please do subscribe, because this is a completely free initiative which we are planning, and every day the top headline will be taken and the needed portions for competitive exams will be discussed in this video. So please hit subscribe before even watching the video. These are the previous episodes, cyclones, the naming of cyclones, then the world's largest iceberg breaking off from Antarctica, and the black fungus. Okay, all these things are being watched by many people across the country and are being appreciated. So please see to it that you also watch it if you have missed. So vaccination is right now open. Everybody should take the vaccine, and which one, that confusion you will get resolved through after watching this video. So 70% of Russia's Sputnik vaccine is to be manufactured in India from August. That is the current affair which came in yesterday's newspaper. So it is made by the Gamaleya Research Institute of Epidemiology and Microbiology in Moscow, Russia. Sputnik is a two-dose COVID-19 vaccine. Okay, same like the Covishield and Covaxin which we have. This is also two-dose, but there is a difference. Okay, that difference we'll discuss in the next slide. Unlike Covishield, which uses a weakened common cold adenovirus that affects chimpanzees, Sputnik 5 makes use of two different human adenoviruses. Meaning, when you take Covishield or Covaxin, you will take two doses, right? The first dose what they give to you or inject into you is the same medicine which will be injected again to you after the particular gap. Okay, 2 weeks or 4 weeks depending on the vaccine. That will be the same thing. But in case of Sputnik, it is two different viruses. So your first dose will be a different medicine and second dose will be a different medicine. Okay, different vaccine, you can tell. So that is a very fundamental difference compared to any other thing. Okay, every other vaccine is like same thing is given two times. But Sputnik, it is two different thing given and it has more efficacy. That is why India has given emergency approval for that. And this virus, if you see adenovirus, it is something which causes this common cold in chimpanzees. Okay, so that virus, a weakened one, meaning it's not a killed one or inactive one, it is live virus but weakened one, that is what is used in Covishield. But another one which affects humans, that is what is used in Sputnik. So that is one fundamental difference between Covishield and Sputnik. Now the vaccine has an efficacy of over 91%. Okay, the Sputnik one, this means that it has the ability to bring down symptomatic COVID-19 cases by over 91% in those vaccinated compared with those who have not received the vaccine. Okay, so it's not like you will never get corona or corona entire thing will wipe off from the world. It is never going to happen. Whatever disease is there in this world now, whichever pandemic has come and gone, the virus will still exist in the environment. But your bodies will be developing antibodies to fight against that. Meaning after taking the two doses and after that, whenever this corona enters your body, you will get it like a normal fever or cold only. Okay, you will not be like having this lung issues and breathing problems and whatever is happening now across the world. That will not happen. That is what is going to happen through the vaccination. So you should understand that vaccination is not going to wipe out. So people can still get corona after vaccinating, but the intensity will reduce. Okay. In India, Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, okay, which is there in Hyderabad. This is the local distribution partner of Sputnik 5. So far, this laboratory has only received 150,000 doses of vaccine from Russia. The company expects more doses soon. According to the agreement with the Russian Direct Investment Fund. Okay, this is where India has signed. Okay, India has signed an agreement with this thing, because that is in charge of signing agreements for supply in vaccine across the world. Okay, Russia said this is what is signing across the world. India is expected to get at least 250 million doses, which will be sufficient to inoculate 125 million people. Okay, because two doses for each person. However, it is unclear by when these doses will be supplied and distributed in India, meaning it has already started coming, but this full 250 million doses, we don't know. So meanwhile, capacity to make 850 million doses of the vaccine is being set up within India itself, okay, through the packs inked with various biotechnology companies. At least, I think 6 to 8 companies are signing agreements with Russia to manufacture it within India. Okay, instead of waiting for them to make it and send across. Now, the first consignment of imported doses of the Sputnik V vaccine landed in India on May 1 and received regulatory clearances from the Central Drugs Laboratory, Kasauli, on May 13. And in Hyderabad, it's actually administered also to few volunteers. It's already administered and it is found to be safe. Okay, just like the other vaccines. Now, the imported vaccine has a price of around 948 per dose. Okay, because obviously it is imported and it's a different thing. Tax also will be there. So, 5% GST is there currently. And the price of vaccine is around 995. Okay, so this is the cost of per dose of this Sputnik vaccine as of now. Okay, but the price might go down once the local supply begins. Okay, once we start, maybe the taxation will be removed and also the cost will go down. Okay, it will not be this much costly. And the current ones which we have, okay, before going to detailing, we'll see the price. As of now, Covishield, which is manufactured by Serum Institute of India, is cheaper. Okay, it is provided to states at rupees 300 per dose. Okay, and in private hospitals, I think around 600 per dose. Okay, these kind of factual things you don't remember because it will keep changing based on the debates which is going on each day. And this Bharat Biotech's Covaxin, okay, which is India's original vaccine. Okay, this Covishield is not actually India's vaccine. I'll tell you details in the next slide. Covaxin is what Indian scientists have developed and India's own vaccine. Okay, this is actually very expensive. This is given at 400 per dose for the states and around 1,200 per dose to private hospital. Okay, which is costlier than Sputnik. Okay, so as of now, before 2-3 days, Covishield and Covaxin was the one which was approved in India. Now Sputnik is also entering the market. Okay, all these three have been approved for use. Now we'll see Covaxin. Covaxin is an inactivated vaccine. Okay, inactivated vaccine means it is made up of killed coronavirus. Okay, dead virus. It is not like the Covishield, which I told earlier, where they will use that weakened version. Okay, this is not weakened. This is like killed, totally killed. So it makes it safe to be injected into the body. Bharat Biotech, a 24-year-old vaccine maker with a portfolio of 16 vaccines, okay, earlier 16 vaccines, exported to 123 countries, used a sample of the coronavirus isolated by India's Institute of National Institute of Virology. Okay, when administered, immune cells can still recognize the dead virus, prompting the immune system to make antibodies against the virus. Okay, so that's how it will work. This dead virus, the immune cells will be able to recognize it and then it will prompt the immune system to make antibodies against this virus. So when the actual virus comes, your body will be ready for it. So the two doses are given 14 to 28 days apart. So this one I put star because this is what was mentioned in all the books and everywhere. But now latest update has come on May 21, 2 days back. Like what should be the gap between two doses? So that I'll show you in that slide when we discuss the latest update. But as of now, it is like this. Okay, you remember like this. And the vaccine has to be stored at 2 degrees Celsius to 8 degrees Celsius. Okay, the temperature. It has to have cold temperatures. And the controversy about this is the efficacy, whether it is actually tested properly and whether it is safe for people. So whoever have used it and what the government has promised and not the government, the laboratories have promised that it is completely safe. Okay, but the efficacy rate, which they tell like 81%, 67%, 92% in each books, each newspaper, based on who is writing the article, it keeps changing. So that is one controversy going on. Okay, but what happened that day was when this was approved. Okay, personalities like including Shashi Tharoor, he tweeted, okay, the Covaxin has not yet had phase 3 trials. Approval was premature and could be dangerous. Okay, so health minister should please clarify its use should be avoided till full trials are over. India can meanwhile start with the AstraZeneca vaccine in the meantime. This AstraZeneca is nothing but the Covishield, which I will tell you in the next slide. Okay, so he is telling Covaxin, why is the hurry to give approval? You could have used this one and there is no safety guarantee for this. Okay, but the DCGI has replied to that. Okay, in the backdrops of report questioning safety of the vaccines, they have told both vaccines are 110% safe. Some side effects like mild fever, pain, allergy are common for every vaccine. Okay, it applies to both Covishield and Covaxin. Okay, we will never approve anything which is if there is the slightest of safety concern. Okay, that is their reply. Okay, if there was some problem, we will never approve it. Okay, in the first place. So that is why this kind of tweets will be there. People will be opposing. That is natural. Okay, everybody will have safety concerns. But the government and the medical teams, they have already confirmed the safety about it. And till now, there is no issues. Okay, based on that. Also, this people getting affected by corona, people use here like you have taken already two doses, still you get COVID and still you die. That happens. Okay, that happens. Maybe there are some doctors case also which is told. These doctors after taking vaccine, they are actually working among the corona patients again. They are living in that environment for 24 hours every day, day in and day out. So obviously they have a higher risk. But normal common people like you and we are going to take this vaccine and we are not going to roam around among COVID patients. Okay. So don't worry about what all rumors spread about these vaccines and all these things. It is being safe, and this is the same vaccine which is being exported across the world, and people across the world is using it. Okay. India is one of the largest producer also of vaccine. That is why now even Sputnik is going to be made in India. Now Covishield, okay, this is the new bottle if you see. Covishield, that is the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, is being manufactured locally by the Serum Institute of India, which is in Pune. Okay, the other one, Bharat Biotech in Hyderabad, and this one, Serum Institute of India. It's taking an vaccine which is made by Oxford, okay, which is like British based, that we have taken and renamed it as Covishield in India. Okay, we are making it now because Serum Institute is the world's largest vaccine manufacturer. It says it is producing more than 60 million doses a month. This vaccine is made from a weakened version of a common cold virus. Okay, so this, if you see, it's a weakened version. As I told earlier in the previous slide, it's a weakened version. It's a live virus which causes common cold, known as adenovirus from chimpanzees. Its genetic material is same as that of the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus. And this spike protein, you would have seen this. It is actually the part of SARS-CoV-2 using which the virus enters a human body cell. Okay, so this thing will look exactly like the spike protein, the genetic material. It is modified to look more like coronavirus, although it cannot cause illness. Okay, that will look like the virus itself, the weakened one, but it will not cause illness. The jab is administered in 2 doses between 4 and 12 weeks apart. This again, I'll tell you the latest update. What is the gap? Now, it can be safely stored at a temperature of 2 degree to 8 degree. So, this is the same temperature storage required. So, India can handle it. India has cold chain and containers where you can store it and transport it. So, Covishield is highly effective and backed by phase 3 trial data from Brazil and United Kingdom. So, that is why people have more trust towards Covishield vaccine, because this one has backed by the proof of phase 3 trials in Brazil and UK. Okay. And also Indians have this thing like, we don't believe anything which is made in India. We believe foreign materials, foreign things. So that is also there. So multiple reasons are there, but both of them are safe for use. And this AstraZeneca is actually a British-Swedish multinational pharmaceutical company. Okay. And Oxford, of course, you know, Oxford is a university where scientists are there. So this has its headquarters in England as well. Okay. So this is completely a British collaboration thing. Now, which vaccine to take? This is the doubt which most of the people have. So, as I told, both are equally safe and you can take any of this. Okay, people from our family, everybody has taken different vaccines. Okay, so it is safe to use whichever. There is no problem with that. But based on a recent article, I will tell you some advantages of one vaccine. Okay, like Covaxin, he is telling some of the advantages. One thing is, it has been clinically proven to be well effective against COVID-19 and may even work in preventing mutant variants. You would have seen like this COVID in the environment, it is changing shape, it is changing this thing, and mutation is happening. Mutation means that only it is changing shape, and it is maybe the virus which is designed, vaccine which is designed may not work now, okay, against the new mutation. But this Covaxin which India has made is telling it will work against the various variants. I think around 64 types of variants. There was a news a few weeks back that Covaxin can fight against all these variants. Okay. So while the vaccine is a traditional model and carries reactogenic side effects, case studies and data collected from vaccination so far have pointed out that out of all the vaccines, Covaxin delivers the least amount of side effects, such as fever, redness, chills or pains at the injection site. Okay. So for a person who is sensitive to pain or worried about side effect, opting for Covaxin would be a safer option. Okay, this again I am telling, this is not to be followed just because you saw in this video. This is just based on a article, which is a recent article in May month from a doctor. Okay, Covaxin also has a shorter dosing timeline. Okay, compared to Covishield, where you have to wait a huge gap between the first dose and second dose, Covaxin, the gap is less. Okay, so that is another advantage. You will get the 2 doses faster. Okay, those with a history or a risk of blood clotting may also be advised to take Covaxin right now, since blood clotting is a reported side effect with Covishield. Okay. However, it is still considered to be a rare after effect. Okay. It doesn't mean like everybody who has blood clotting will have a problem, but rarely that side effect has been reported. So if you have any situation like this, okay, you can go for Covaxin. That is what this doctor is advising. However, older people, those using any form of blood thinning medication, may be advised to not take Covaxin. Okay, so this is again, he's telling who should not take Covaxin. So these are all his viewpoint based on his research. Okay, now both the vaccines, okay, even if they do not fully prevent COVID infections, both Covishield and Covaxin have been known to cut down severity and mortality risk associated with infection. So both are effective. That is the end line you can tell. Okay, now I'll just compare the worldwide vaccines which is there. Okay, what is available? So this one is a RNA vaccine. What is RNA vaccine? Like India is also developing an mRNA vaccine, the first India's one. That and all we'll discuss in a separate video because it's a separate science topic. So RNA-based vaccine, these two are there, which has actually 95% plus efficiency. Okay, this is efficacy. This is going to work better. But problem is, see the temperature. It has to be stored in minus 80 to minus 60. Okay, not like the other one which you saw like 2 to 8. So these two, India does not have the capacity right now to store this much dose of vaccine, this kind of cold temperature, and then transport it from one place to another. India don't have the capacity right now. That is why we are not preferring this, even though this has higher efficacy than Covishield and Covaxin. Okay, then viral vector, meaning virus based, meaning it will not have killed virus, it will have a weakened coronavirus. So not coronavirus, weakened virus will be used here. Okay, so Oxford AstraZeneca, which is our Covishield, that I told you, it will use a weakened virus. And all this, if you see, is two dose. Okay, everything is two dose except for this Johnson & Johnson, which is one dose. Okay, but the efficacy rate is very less for that. That is why we have not approved it. Okay, in India also, we are trying to make it, but it's still not given approval. Okay, and the Sputnik is also two dose. This also I told you, it is the weakened virus of two different. One difference is these two are two doses, two different medicines in Sputnik's case. All others, the first dose and second dose are same. Okay, so this is viral vector based this thing. And this is inactivated one, the China which is using, and what India has developed Covaxin, all these are inactivated virus, meaning killed virus or dead virus. That is what is being used. So I hope you clearly understand the differences. Okay, RNA based, weakened virus based, and dead virus based. Okay, then protein based one is there, Novavax, which is also India is collaborating with them now and trying to put it in there, because this is also temperature, if you see, it's 2 to 8 degree and we can store it. Also, India is trying to collaborate with this. That also I'll show you in the next slide. Okay, like what all India is now working on. So this is the comparison. Now efficacy, if you take Bharat Biotech's Covaxin is 80%. This Moderna and this one, as I told, is above 95%. And this Covishield is 82%. And this Sputnik is 91%. So if you see, we will have this Bharat Biotech one, this one, Oxford one, and then Sputnik one. This is what we are going to have as of now. Okay, as and when I'm recording this video, this is the one. Now this is the update on May 21. ICMR has said, okay, Indian Council of Medical Research have said that Covishield's first dose develops strong immunity than Covaxin. Okay, the first dose which is given, right? They are telling Covishield's first dose gives more immunity. Okay, the government recently accepted the COVID-19 working group's recommendation for extending the gap between the two doses of Covishield vaccine from 6 to 8 weeks to 12 to 16 weeks. Okay, 12 to 16 weeks, it's like 3 to 4 months. So Covishield, now the gap is you take the first dose and then after 3 to 4 months only, you will take the second dose. Okay. However, the dosage interval for Covaxin has been left unchanged and remains 4 weeks. Okay, so 4 weeks means it's around 1 month. So here it is 3 to 4 months gap and here it is 1 month gap. Okay. The decision to increase the interval between two doses of Covishield was taken because the first dose of Covishield can develop a stronger immunity, which is same as the headline which I told. Okay, so that is why it needs times. Okay. The immunity of the first dose of Covishield was found to be strong and that the 3 month gap will give better result. Okay, that is why it is increased. So just remember, okay, now I hope you understand clearly when I tell Covishield, what is it, Covaxin, what is it, which is using dead virus, which is using inactive weakened virus. So all those things should be clear by now. Okay, I've already explained. And this is like final slide, who should not take the vaccines. Okay, so that again, like if you have history of allergies, okay, high fever, bleeding disorder, already received another vaccine, then any other serious issue with the supervisor, vaccine shot supervisor will tell you. Okay, so that kind of, this is for Covaxin and this is for Covishield. If you see, it's again same thing, allergic, that kind of thing. Also, who is pregnant, breastfeeding, and who are under 18 years old. Okay, now also if you see, 18 to 45 is open. Okay, and 45 above was already open. But below 18 is not open. So below 18, you should not take. The others, whatever is told, these people should not take the vaccine. Okay, whatever you see in screen. Any other vaccine candidates, as I told, in Ahmedabad, this is being developed. Then Hyderabad-based one company, which is India's private vaccine-making company, first private vaccine-making company, they are collaborating with USA to make a vaccine. Then this Johnson & Johnson, which I told, which has lesser efficacy, that is like collaborating with Hyderabad. Okay. Then here HGCO19, India's first mRNA vaccine. This I told, I'll discuss in a separate video. Okay. This is being made by Pune-based Genova in collaboration with Seattle-based something. Okay, so they are also trying to make. So this also, like I told you, RNA-based vaccines, which is in USA, it has 95% efficacy. So maybe this, when it comes, this also will have. So this is like going on. Okay, and one nasal vaccine is being made by Bharat Biotech. Then a second vaccine is being developed by Serum Institute of India. Okay, which is Novavax, the protein-based one. Okay, so that one is also in discussion. So like that, these many vaccines are going on, but only three has got approval. Now, which countries are signing up for India's vaccines? Okay, right now, if you see, in March, India has placed a temporary hold, okay, because second wave came. But before that, India shipped 64 million doses of vaccine to 86 countries in Latin America, Caribbean, Asia, Africa, almost everywhere India has sent across. That too, both Covishield and Covaxin. People have used both. So that is why, that too in the form of gift also. And that is why people are all now thankful to India and everybody are helping us back also. Okay, even Russia is sending this many doses because India has helped and stood for the world when India's cases were less and we did not expect a second wave. Okay, so that time we were doing good. So now they are all helping us to recover from the pandemic. So this is, I hope it's given a clear idea. Covaxin is what, Covishield is what. So you can take any vaccine. Both are fine. There is no harm in anything. Okay, the side effects, any vaccine. Okay, you leave this and take any like polio vaccine, rabies vaccine, any vaccine you take. Sometimes people will get fever. Okay, that is natural for any vaccine. That has nothing to do with this particular corona vaccine or corona disease. Okay, so we'll wind up this with a MCQ. This is actually a geography question. If you see, Indian naval ship Kesari reached Port Victoria in a particular place to provide COVID-19 related medicine. So in June, current affair, it is mentioned, okay, we have given this much to this thing and Port Victoria received it. So actually, you have to find out that even though it's a corona related thing, it's a geography question. So where is it? Mauritius, Maldives, Seychelles or Palau? Okay, so tell in comment section because this is put just to make it interactive. So subscribe to this channel because we want to give more and more content oriented videos like this every single day. So you have to subscribe and give your feedback. I'll come up with the next episode tomorrow. Thank you and have a nice day.